Hello, I'm Brad Bird. Okay. Oh!
There's not many people in Hollywood who do story the way Brad Bird does. From a young age, Brad Bird was a visual storyteller.
They were absolutely a normal 3-year-old level of drawing. What was weird is they were meant to be viewed in a certain order. And I think in my own weird way, from the very beginning, I was trying to make movies.
Brad Bird went on to study animation at CalArts and was then hired by Disney Animation shortly after graduating. After working on The Iron Giant, Bird was hired to work for Pixar, and it was there he wrote, pitched, and directed the film The Incredibles, which went on to be a huge success. Fast forward to 2015, Brad Bird directed and co-wrote the film Tomorrowland. Regardless of how either film did at the box office, each one was made for the same reason, to tell a story. In his career, Brad Bird puts a strict focus on the idea of story first. In both Tomorrowland and Incredibles, Brad Bird promotes the idea of story first in two different ways: his mentality on film and his collaboration with the crew.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away.
First, I'll be talking about his mentality on film and how that corresponds with Tomorrowland. If you haven't seen 2015's Tomorrowland, I highly suggest you watch it. The film tells the story of a girl, Casey, who is trying to go to Tomorrowland, the city of the future. Alongside Casey is an android named Athena and Tomorrowland exile Frank Walker. The film critiques the world's pessimistic view of the future as well as our role and influence on it. Brad Bird's story-first mentality is very much shown throughout Tomorrowland. When it was released, critics were not fans. Many complained that the film didn't have enough Tomorrowland in it, and others claimed it lacked a lot of action they expected from the trailers. Looking back at the film, it would have been so much easier to give the critics what they wanted to make a profit. The film could have taken place almost entirely in Tomorrowland, and there could have been lots of sci-fi action scenes, and it probably would have done a lot better at the box office. Instead, Brad told the story he wanted to tell, not the one the audience expected. In an interview, he said this:
Tomorrowland as a place was only going to be part of this story. It's a lot of it is the road to getting there. It's kind of like Wizard of Oz in that. You don't spend the movie dancing around Oz. You kind of go to Oz and then go away from Oz in Wizard of Oz. So Wizard of Oz is more about the journey, and I think this film is too.
Everyone wanted a film in Tomorrowland, but his story was about the journey to get there.
When you're doing a story, if you're really doing a story and not just repeating the last success, you're just, what the hell, you know, I think this would be cool. I hope, yeah, sounds great, you know, I mean, you're gambling.
In the end, I think it worked out for the better. I really enjoyed Tomorrowland, and I think it definitely has some hard lessons that we can all learn from.
I'm afraid the world is ending.
It is certain, it is unavoidable, and it is coming.
Brad Bird's story-first mentality is also shown in how he collaborates with the crew. For this part, I'm going to be looking at The Incredibles, Brad Bird's first feature film at Pixar. One of my favorite stories about the production of The Incredibles was how Bird pushed the film to its technological limit. There were two times this happened. The first was the physics of the character's hair. It's really interesting how they did it, and I highly suggest you watch The Incredibles special features to learn more. The second time this happened went hand in hand with the story.
But that little fabric thing where he works his hand through there is like one guy took 3 months on it.
They tried the best they could, but Bird kept pushing until they finally figured out how to make it work.
You got
to
put your hand through it?
Yeah, and is there any way he can just kind of hold it and describe moving
there's
his
a
hand
hole
through
in
it?
Can oh, we do look, it with... there's a hole. Yeah, that'll yeah. work, won't
can
it?
Can we just cut to his face and hear sound of him moving his hand through it? They so wanted to avoid that shot, and I said, no, the point of the story is that he's torn his old suit and he wants to fix it.
Bird's story first interactions with the crew also goes directly with writing and planning the story itself.
The idea to make Bob less bald came up. I got angry because I thought, well, we've had him like this for 3 years and now it's a problem?
I hate that because everyone hates it, but they're still going, well, okay, we can make this work. And it's like this, it's all right, okay, all right.
One of the things I like most about Brad Bird is that he listens and often changes his mind for the sake of the story.
A lot of times I'm very clear on what I want, but there come times where I'm not totally sure that my way is the absolute best way.
Great thing about Brad, he'll take good ideas wherever they come from.
He asks you, he wants to know what you think.
The fact that he will admit he made a mistake or that his way wasn't the best is one of the better examples of his story first mentality.
Make it okay for people to challenge an idea or two. The good ideas can withstand it, and the weaker ideas fall away and make room for something.
If you repress, you depress, darling. To impress, you must express. That's too much of it, darling, too much.
The common theme of all these examples is simply this. Brad Bird doesn't let anything drive the story, except for the story. He didn't let the critics or box office drive the story of Tomorrowland, and he didn't let the technology drive the story of The Incredibles. Instead, he let the story shape itself. The only time the stories ever changed was when he or someone working on the film came up with a better alternative to improve the overall story.
Frozen going, doof, 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 doof.
Brad Bird will always be someone that I admire, both as a filmmaker and person.
Is it more expensive for people down the road, or is it pretty much the same as anything else?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah, we don't know yet. We haven't gotten it into lighting yet to test that.
His mindset is something I hope to keep at the forefront of any and all projects I do. If we can learn anything from Brad Bird, it's that the story should always come first.
Oh, well, everybody's heard about the bird. Bird, bird, bird. The bird's a winner. Well, the bird, bird, bird. Bird is...
I did not come to Pixar to do a CG film. I was interested in coming to Pixar because they protected stories.
The bird's a winner. Well, the bird, bird, bird. The bird's a winner. Well, the...